from your Michigan. This is Mathematics Fundamental Tutor. You can visit me on my YouTube account, codename Physics Mathematics Fundamentals. Thank you. Today we are going to further mathematics under Mechnics. And the topic under Mechnics we are taking is about momentum. Momentum is simply the measure of the quantity of motion that a body possesses. And the value for momentum is even as the velocity of that body multiplied by the mass of the body. So that means the higher the velocity of the body at a constant mass, the higher the momentum. And then the higher the mass of the body at a constant velocity, the higher the momentum. So in a nutshell, momentum is simply the measure of the motion of a body. And mathematically, momentum is given as the mass of that body times the velocity of that body. And velocity is simply defined as the speed of an object taken in a given direction. Thank you. Now we move down to, first and foremost, before we do any problem under this topic, momentum, collision of bodies, we are talking about body colliding. When one body is moving in one direction, colliding with another body, whether the two bodies are moving in the same direction and colliding, or they are moving in the opposite direction and yes, they collide. There are two types of collision. We have what is called elastic collision and inelastic collision. In the elastic collision, the body, they move apart after collision. In the inelastic collision, the body sticks together. Thank you. Now, the law of linear conservation of momentum. The law says that for a given system of before collision equal to the total momentum of that body after collision. That means for a system of colliding body, the total momentum of that system remains constant. And consider this scenario. We are having body A of mass A moving with velocity A, and body B of mass B moving with velocity B. If these two bodies collide, whether they are moving in the same direction or they are moving in opposite direction, when they collide, the total momentum before collision will be equal to the total momentum after collision. And look at body A and B. The momentum of body A is simply the mass of body A times the velocity of body A, and the momentum of body B is simply the mass of body B times the initial velocity of body B. So when you see U, we are talking about the velocity of individual body before collision, and V is the velocity of the body after collision. Now, if two bodies stick together, then after collision, the total momentum is the sum of velocity. And this parameter, they are as written here to indicate what each of these stand for. For instance, look at this example. A body of mass 20 kg moving with a velocity of 8 meters per second collides with another body of mass 30 kg moving with a velocity of 50 meters per second. If the two bodies move together in the same direction, means if this body moves in this direction, this other body moves in this direction, or if this body moves in this direction, the other body moves in this direction before collision. Now, the question says, if the two bodies move together in the same direction after collision, find their common velocity. If they move in A, same direction before collision, B, opposite direction before collision. Now, if the body moves in the same direction before collision, now we have a sign convention. When the body moves from left to right, we take our velocity to be positive. When the body moves from right to left, we take our velocity to be negative. This sign convention is made use of in this our calculation here. Now, for instance, if these two bodies move, the two of them move in the same direction that is positive, that means the value of this velocity will be positive, the value of this velocity will be what? Positive. Now, if the body sticks together after collision, then the momentum after collision is the addition of these two masses times the common velocity. And the question asks us to find the common velocity under this condition. Now, the total momentum before collision is as calculated below. The momentum of body A before collision is the mass of the body A times its own velocity. That's what we have here. And the momentum of body B before collision is the mass of body B times its own velocity. This is what we have here. Since both of them are moving in the same direction, the value of our velocity here will be positive. Opening the bracket, we have this calculation out. And then when you add these two masses together, we have 50. Therefore, we want to make V subject of a formula. Adding this together, we have this. Then to get V, divide both sides by 50. So we have this. So the common velocity after collision now is 62 meter per second. This occurs when the common velocity and the two body move in the same direction before collision. Now, the question 2 says that if the two bodies move together in the same direction after collision, find the common velocity. If both of them move before collision, they move in opposite direction. In this case, the body move in opposite direction. In this case, now the body A, let's say it's taking the positive direction, which is positive velocity. Body B, let's say it's moving in the opposite direction, then the velocity of this body B will be negative. You can see that when they move in the same direction, they have positive value, the velocity. But when they move in opposite direction, one is having positive value of velocity, the other one is having negative value of velocity. Now, the momentum of body A before collision is 20 times its own positive velocity. The momentum of body B before collision is its own mass times the negative velocity. Now, which is equal to the momentum after collision, and the momentum after collision is T, the total mass times the common velocity. Opening it with this, take away that, is equal to 50V. Now, we make this, which is the common velocity, the subject of formula. Now, we discover that the common velocity, when the two body move in opposite direction before collision, is 2 meter per second. You can visit me more on other aspects of further mathematics and physics on my YouTube, which is Orekoya Olusegun Mathematics Physics Fundamentals. Thank you.